What's good, you guys? It's Rio, and here's how I made the beat for Jumpin' by Autumn.
I seen the shit in my future, this shit was way too easy like Gunna. AR-15 carbon, maple grips, two mags, we hunt. Who the fuck else you know, do the shit like this, hell yeah, I run it.
Around October, me and all the internet money guys, we went out to New York for some sessions. One of the A&Rs, John Hicks, he set up a session with Autumn. And I had worked with Autumn before. We had this song called Loco that me and Bristow produced.
Had a cup that cool, got tired of that fuck, though. I'ma fuck with you cause you free promo.
We never like linked up in person before. I wasn't really sure what vibes he would want. I prepared some beat, but we got in and he was like, bro, I just want some like super hard shit. So I was like, dang, I don't know if I really have that on hand. So I just locked in. I put on headphones. I made this shit in like 6 minutes. I don't know. It was cool working with him for the first time in person. I feel like there's always like a different vibe when you get in person versus just sending out packs. Man, the vibes were fire. I like working in New York. He pulled up. We did a couple songs that day, but Jumpin' is definitely like the craziest one we did. It was fire, bro. Autumn is cool as fuck. When he was recording that song, I could even just hear it through the headphones. I could tell that it was crazy. I was so hyped about it. But when I heard the shout out though, I was definitely hyped about it. Like, I've gotten a couple shout outs in songs, but that one's probably my favorite. But yeah, let's get into it. All right, I started off with this art from Expand called Syncope. Sounds like this. And I just clicked in this pattern right here. So at first it sounded like this. And then I was like, dang, it could use a little more flavor. So I put this preset in Effectrix called Backwards Vocals on it. And then I just right clicked here and automated the mix on the Effectrix. So as you can see right here before the start of the song, the Effectrix turns on. That's how I got that like reversing effect right before the drop. All right, after that, I just threw some drums in. All of them were from this kit by my boy Mingo, so y'all should go check him out. I threw on just a normal clap pattern, and then I did this hi-hat pattern. It's like a little stuttered. It goes like this. And on the hi-hats, I actually put a little bit of delay with these settings. So it's just a little 1/4 delay. And then also this plug-in KHS reversers. It gives the hi-hats like a little bit of delay and like reversing effect. But I just turned the mix down around here like 1/4. So it just reverses a little bit. There are actually two 808s in the song. One of them is just a normal spins. And another one is the Brashed 808 from that Mingo kit. First, I just clicked in this pattern with the spins. I feel like it just adds so much to the bounce, like when those 808s go up high, there's like high C sharp notes. And then after I added that, then I added the second 808 just with this pattern. So first it plays the root note and then it goes down 4 to that A. All right, next I added some snares and perks. We got this snare that I added, and then I also got this one, then this little perk. So with all those drums, the pattern sounds like this. And with this snare at the end, I just added this roll. It's just doing triplets. Two of the triplets just have like little rolls in them. So that sounds like this. And then I had this spins 808. I duplicated the spins and made just like a little part of the pattern for the end of it. So it goes along with that snare roll I added. They're both playing triplets is what it sounds like. I feel like those little pockets in the beat just add like so much bounce to it. Just like doing those fast triplets. All right, so all together, this is what all the drums sound like. I only had 9 drum sounds in it, but I feel like the patterns are just so spazzy that it like adds a lot to it. You don't need a million sounds in your beat if you just have the patterns going crazy. All right, the next thing I added, I opened up another instance of Expand, and I got these woodpecker bells, and I did a pretty simple pattern. Just a little arp, just playing 3 notes. Without the Effectrix, it sounds like this. But I felt like that sounded a little bit bland, so I routed it to the same mixer track as that ARP, and I put the Effectrix on it, and I feel like it sounds way crazier with the Effectrix on it. That's all the sounds I had in the beat. Other than that, I just put a limiter on the master and turned the attack, release, and sustain down. I know a lot of people use a soft clipper, but I like how the limiter sounds. But other than that, all we had was the Effectrix on that band ARP and then the delay and reverser on the hi-hats. Everything else was just dry. I don't really mix my beats that much. I kind of just go with the flow. I mean, if that shit slaps, it's valid. You don't have to do much, but man, I feel like you just have to find a way to never feel like you're work. Like, even though this is my job and I clock in every day, and sometimes there are sessions where maybe I'm not in the right mood, I don't want to be working then. Just like, you have to find a way to always make it fun. Cause like, you could have all the hits and all the accolades and everything, but that doesn't even make you feel better about it. Like, you just have to love music and love what you're making. Cause like, you're just chasing placements, you're chasing money and all that. Like, it's just, you're never gonna be satisfied by that. You're gonna get a placement and then you're gonna be like, damn, I want another one. You get $1,000 off of music, you want 10,000. You just have to find a way to like, just love music and love what you do, and all the accolades and everything will come with it. Like, with time, you know? Anyways, this is what the final beat sounds like. That's how I made the beat for Jumpin'. Thanks for watching. Let us know what other breakdowns or other videos you guys want. But we'll catch you guys in the next one. 4-4 Bulldog, shoot by the 6s, watch how bad we slow.